Hello, this is foodoffensive.com's weekly video broadcast. I came to you last week from a big box store looking at all of the 4th of July goodies that you can buy coming up and the things that are in there we don't want to try to avoid. And you can see this week it's a little cloudier than it was last time. I'm not squinting so much in the video, but I'm gonna go in this store here and kind of give you a rundown of the same products that I looked at last week that are terrible for you. But I'm going to point out the things, the direct alternatives to those that are healthy for you. And of course, you're going to see the prices that aren't, you know, I'm not going to point the prices out, but you'll see it in the video probably. The fact that you might pay a little more in some cases, there's some times when we pay the same or less for a healthier option, which is a real bonus. So keep that in mind. Of course, you're going to pay a little bit more for something that's healthier, but why not look at your health and think about the long-term effects of what you're eating? Maybe you'll feel a little better, you'll feel a little bit healthier, and also later down the road, you won't have all the various kinds of diseases that we're plagued with today. So we're going to go inside and take a look, and then we'll come back out and have a brief little closing. So here I am at inside the juice aisle of a more natural type grocery store, or a healthy type grocery store. And as you can see, I mean, it's all glass. There's very few plastic jugs, but even the plastic ones, you know, they're a higher quality, 100% juice, no added sugar, things like that. And of course you have organic, the Santa Cruz brand has organic there. So, you know, you can look at the label and it uses filtered water, organic cane juice, and organic lemon juice and concentrate. So all organic, and then again, it's all in glass. There's really no plastics and no high fructose corn syrup, of course. And now I'm on the aisle that has the sodas and the chips. I mean, this would be like your junk food aisle, really, you know, looking at the other video from last week. You really, of course, it's a larger store last week, so you're going to have more items and more of the standard sodas, but this one has more of the natural stuff. You got all the cream sodas and things like that. I just wanted to look at these cream sodas to see what's in them, and it looks like it's sweetened with stevia, but instead of the high fructose corn syrup. If I can focus in for you here, purified water, GMO-free caramel color. See, you gotta think about that. They point that out. They know people are looking for that, especially people that shop in these types of stores. So, no preservatives, no sugar, no sugar alcohol, no gluten. So, I mean, they've learned to market it that way, and so that's really cool that they did that. I mean, there's a lot of canned sodas too. I myself don't drink out of aluminum, but just a personal preference, having aluminum leach into the drink. After learning a little bit more about that, I don't do that. But anyway, the contents inside would be a lot better than your typical sodas. And of course, looking at all these chips too, you don't see the normal brands. I mean, one of the mainline ones that I can tell here is the Kettle brand. That's one of the more mainline ones. There's the Stacy's down there, but you're not gonna see the Lay's and all that, because Frito-Lay products, of course, you know, we've got all kinds of stuff in there, and then, of course, you're not going to see Doritos. So this is your alternative, and really, you know, these bags of chips are $2 for $3. A lot of times, you can't get Lay's chips for that, and I know things are different prices, and you can get things on sale, but like I've said before, what's your health worth, really? I mean, what is your health worth? It's got potatoes, which the number one, by the way, if you're wondering, the number one ingredient in potato chips, when you buy them in the bag, should be potatoes. I know that's kind of weird, but that's what it should be. Sunflower oil, safflower oil, they point that out. They use that as a big ingredient in here, and they use that instead of like canola oil or soy oil, which is going to be GMO. So a lot of stuff in here, and no MSG. You know, no MSG, that's not uncommon to see that in regular chips. So no MSG, none of that. So, you know, you're looking at a lot healthier products, and there are alternatives, just like I said, and many of options. So let's look at these cheese puffs, something that would be hugely processed item if you were to buy it in a normal grocery store of a normal brand. And of course the cheese products usually have the MSG in them as a flavor. But looking at this cornmeal, there is some canola in there, but for what these are, you're not getting into the MSG and things like that in this, and it's a more natural product. You know, if you're going to eat something like a cheese puff, which would normally be highly processed, you don't want to, you know, you want to stay away from the Cheeto brand and the Dorito brand and all that. So that's their junk aisle. This is the version of the junk aisle. So if you had an option, you could come here, and if you were insistent on getting some snack items, which aren't a bad thing, you should look at some of the alternatives here. And let's just look at, I've had these myself personally, these Honey Grahams, or they're called Bunny Grahams, but basically it's an all-natural, Annie's is known for all-natural products, non-GMO type boxed products and processed products. So, you know, we buy the mac and cheese version. Annie's has a mac and cheese line, and it's more natural and better for you. It's all organic, like these snacks here are all organic. It does contain wheat ingredients. It has to dispel that, but you know, you've got organic whole grain wheat flour. There is some vegetable oil in there, and it's safflower and sunflower, which is good. So there's other options here for you and your kids to eat. If your kids want snacks, you know, that's, you're not going to get away from that with the kids. And so this is what they have, and these are the options that they have. And so there are things out there you can do, and that's the intention of this video, to kind of counterbalance the one I did last week, is to do one this week that has the alternative to some of that bad stuff that we saw last week. And so looking at condiments, just like we did in the other store as well, you've got all these condiments, about the same selection, but look how many ketchups. I mean, you're talking at least 5 different brands, if not 6 different brands of ketchup, and not a single one has high fructose corn syrup. So it's the options are there. The thing, you know, the idea is there, the opportunity is there to get the real stuff. So of course, sweet relish. It is possible to get sweet relish. That doesn't have high fructose corn syrup in it to sweeten the pickles. So, and it's organic there. There is a little bit of preservative type stuff, but you don't have the high fructose corn syrup that the other brand, the Heinz brand of sweet relish, is going to have. And then just right next to it here, you've got all of these barbecue sauces as well. They got the Stubbs here. You're not going to find any high fructose corn syrup there. And you can get that at a normal store. You don't have to go to some, you know, crazy health store or something to get it. And even this Guy Fieri's, you know, you would think it's kind of a mainline thing, kind of, since he's a big celebrity chef and such, you know, you don't have the high fructose corn syrup in here. So there's plenty of things there that are an option to your barbecue, your 4th of July barbecue, and you can stay away from some of this other stuff. And just like with the dressings as well, you've got the Annie's is a major, a brand, a recognized brand, that's becoming more and more common in mainline stores, and many of other, I mean, you're talking at least 12 different brands of product here, and it's all natural type things, and alternatives to your normal dressings that have all the other stuff in it that we looked at in the video last week. And so just like I showed you at the other store with the end cap here, they've got an end cap with all their some of their canned goods and their beans and things like that. And with, of course, 4th of July coming up here in a few days, you can see all the beans that they have. You're going to do baked beans and things like that. They have that. But I wanted to point out especially this Eden brand. This is one of the few brands of canned goods in our research that have been shown to be BPA-free can lining. And so at home, when we absolutely have to use canned goods, we try to only get the Eden brand. And so, of course, you are going to pay a little bit more for this brand, but like I said, what's it worth to you in the long run? And so you've got, not only do you have an organic product here, this is actually a full, like, Cajun red beans and rice, kind of a whole meal in here, but you can see here, BPA-free lining along with the gluten-free, you know, this, those are two huge hot buttons right now for marketing and for what people are looking for. And so it goes on to kind of say that it's all that at the bottom. It says BPA-free, bisphenol A-free can lining, so it's very good. Very, very good. So here I am looking at the sausages. You can't have a 4th of July barbecue cookout without having a hot dog. And looking, of course, the store's not going to have your Bar S and all those other cheap brands that are at Walmart and Target, but or your mainline grocery store, but they're going to have something that looks like a hot dog here. It's an all-beef frank. It just looks just like what you would get. But this one's an all-organic grass-fed beef. And look, it says no nitrites or nitrates added. They specifically point that out. And so that's very important to look for in any type of sausage, any bacon, anything you look at there. And this one as well, this Fearless brand, it's an uncured beef frank, no antibiotics, all vegetarian feeding. You know, they feed cows what cows are meant to be fed and not other cows. I know that's crazy too, but and then there you go, no nitrates or nitrites added. So now you're gonna pay a little more for these, but you're not gonna get all the junk that's in the stuff that's in the other stuff. So week's video, I pointed out the fact that you might have strawberry shortcake as one of your dessert options on your barbecue buffet this 4th of July and into the weekend, but I pointed out the fact that the whipped topping that you can buy frozen if you're in a hurry or want something that'll hold up in the heat, it's not going to have real cream in it. That's why it doesn't say whipped cream. And I'm looking here in the frozen section, hoping that there might be an alternative to that, and that might be one thing I might not be able to find an alternative to. Well, wait. Real heavy cream is an alternative to whipped topping, so I guess you do have an alternative there. I understand it's more expensive and harder to hold up in the picnic setting and in the heat outside, but you know, dairy is dairy and whipped topping is not. So there you have it. We saw all different kinds of things in there, pretty much an alternative version for everything that we saw, you know, that you want to avoid. You can still have your outdoor barbecue, you can still have all of your same items, but spend a little bit more money, take a little bit more time, find the stuff that's good for you, and hopefully this video was informative and we can get back to healthier eating and get away from some of these things I've been pointing out in all my videos. But until next time, this is foodoffensive.com's video broadcast coming at you from the front lines of the food supply. Thank you for joining.